Hello.
Why don't you just tell us a little bit about yourself?
So I'm an 18-year-old senior at Pine Grove. We found out that I had Hodgkin's lymphoma in October.
The kind of disease that Michelle has, it's called nodular sclerosing Hodgkin's. It basically means that you have lymph nodes and then there are multiple areas where they kind of collect together and make these nodules, and then it just makes these fibrous tissue.
So we got a chest x-ray and it looked like I had pneumonia because my lungs were just completely clouded over. So I was admitted to St. Joseph's Hospital in Reading, where they did a biopsy on my left lymph node under my armpit, and it turned out I had Hodgkin's lymphoma, so we started chemo within the week after I got my port in my chest. So yeah, that's how I got my diagnosis.
The night before I found out, Michelle had texted me and she was like, "Hey, I need to talk to you about something tomorrow." When I saw her the next morning, I was like, "Is everything okay?" And she said, "No, not really." And I was like, "You aren't gonna die, are you?" And then she just looked at me and my heart sank and I was like, "Oh no." And then she told me that she had the cancer and I was just in shock.
We gave her multiple options and the treatment that she chose was the multiple chemotherapy agents that at higher dosing. Luckily, she responded very well to that and she was disease-free after those two cycles. And then the plan was to get her to radiation, since she was a slow responder to begin with, to kind of radiate areas where she had disease, which was her lungs and her spleen. So that's kind of where she is right now.
As I'm sitting there really worried about the cost of it. Oh, sure, the insurance will knock it back, but it'd still be a couple $1,000 every time I got treatment out of my pocket. Then it was funny how Dr. Comito and the nurse practitioner were smiling. And they go, "We have a plan for that." And they explain what the Four Diamonds Fund did. And I'm like, "Holy crap." And it just still brings tears to my eyes to know that that's available, because I tell you what, I don't know what would have happened if I had to sit there and pay those bills. It probably would have put me in the hospital with a heart attack or a stroke. You know, the pressure I felt by that time. So just with that, knowing that and what they do.
You tell a couple people where she's at right now, and then the next person comes up and says, "I'm sure you don't want to talk about this again, but I really don't mind, as long as I know that person is sincere about asking about Michelle. I don't mind, because it's therapy too to talk about it, and it's the support page makes it so easy that you don't have to call 500 people to tell them what's going on. They can find it out on there. But just the support that we feel when we walk in down at Hershey is just so helpful. Because you know you have a team there. And they all know Michelle. And it's an easy transition from one place to another.
I wear wigs pretty much all the time because I worry about like how other kids will like view the situation, like, and I don't want to trigger them in case someone else in their family has cancer. We got my wig made out of my own hair, actually, just so I wouldn't feel weird having a wig with someone else's hair on my face. People made hats for me. I have about 20 hats and they're all different colors, so I just match with my outfit. I try to match with my outfit most of the time. I remember going to my one friend's house the night that we found out, and I was just like, "Cancer is just a word. It's not going to change anything. You'll see me all the time." And then maybe about a week later, we were driving to like one of my appointments, and I was just like, "I was really stupid to say that. It's not just a word. It's going to affect the rest of my life forever now." No, my friends have become a lot closer to me, and my family's just really pulled together. But I'm still really involved in school. I'm our yearbook editor this year. I'm in our musical quiz bowl team, band. I'm also a 4-H club, Grange, church, pretty much everything. I didn't stop. So, yeah.
Recently, Michelle had a pretty significant hurdle to jump over. She had come in with visual defects and was found to have a little blood clot in her brain causing her to bleed, and that caused her to have visual field defects. And I think that was probably just as scary, if not scarier, than when she first learned that she had cancer. And that's when she had a meltdown and just kind of broke out and just cried for a little bit. And I think anybody would, and I think she handled the situation very well. But that's when I knew that that was her breaking point. As a person, I think Michelle was very mature to begin with. She came in with knowing what she wanted and was very involved in her care and had asked appropriate questions and was not dependent on her parents to make any kind of decisions, though they were involved in decision making, but she pretty much took the lead of her care. She took ownership of her own disease and would ask us questions outside of our visits, email me or Dr. Comito. She took responsibility of what she was going through and handled it very well. She's grown, I think, as a person, and I think going through this journey in her life has made her a stronger human being and has, in my opinion, taught her how to deal with things that she may not have learned had she not had to go through what she went through. There were obviously moments where, you know, she felt weaker than she thought she would and had moments where she broke down and had lots of obstacles, but I think we pulled through pretty well, and, you know, she understands what she has to do and what her future entails. So I think she's taken ownership of who she is and where she needs to go, which is very, very good for her.
Seeing my brother and sister in college, it makes me realize that I want it too. And like, I've always liked planning to go to college. I've been looking forward to it since about fifth grade, I think. I'd already been really interested in IUP before, and I was just like, I can do 4 hours, I think. But now we're still applying to Penn State school, like our closest branch at Penn State, just in case I can't go away to college next year for a semester or something, just so I don't get behind in my college classes. But I still plan to go to IUP because I just need to get away from home. My mom's sick of me, I think. Some things that I do more are probably, I listen to music because music really has helped me. Like, growing up, I listened to music all the time because of being a band, being so musically inclined. But now, like, I look this, like, the meanings in songs, like the song I Live by One Republic right now has really held a lot of meaning, just because I don't want to look back on my life. Like, if I can't beat the cancer and say that my life wasn't worth living, like, I want to make a difference in the world. Like, I guess that's like my complex with going into political science in college next year. Like, I just want to make a difference. I've learned to appreciate the finer things in life because I used to just, one activity to the next. I wasn't really home a lot. But now I appreciate, like, I want to be able to enjoy the things in my life and I want to relax. So I guess it's helped me to unwind a little bit, so.